Hey everyone, it's Maggie from Perusall Support, and today I am going to walk you through setting up peer review and then what it looks like from the instructor's perspective when it's live in the course. When you're in the assignment tab, you're going to select Add Assignment and then select Peer Review Assignment. There are four phases to peer review. The first phase is the student work submission phase. This is where students will upload their PDFs to the assignment. If you want, you can enable a late submission deadline. With this, you can also apply a submission penalty. So if students upload their work after the initial deadline, you can put X amount of penalty towards the overall score for the assignment. The next phase is the student review deadline. So this is when students in the course are assigned their peers' documents to review. And in this phase, students will provide comments, they will provide feedback, and they will also fill out a rubric if you so desire to add one. The third phase is the instructor review phase. This is when the assignment totally closes off from the students and you, the instructor, will see what is going on in the assignment. You can check out who is saying what on what paper. You can see what the reviews for the rubric are saying, and you can choose to omit comments from the overall feedback. You can also add your own comments. If you do not want this third phase in the peer review, you can always select omit instructor review period. The final phase is the author review and response period. So this is where the assignment opens back up, and now the authors of the paper can see what their peers have provided them. They can look at the overall feedback and they can respond to comments, which also then stirs deeper discussion into their work. If you prefer not to have a rubric, you can omit this by selecting this setting here. And if you do not want peer reviewers to leave overall feedback, you can also take this away by enabling this here. If you want to learn more about rubrics and scoring, we will have links in the description below of this video. So I'm just going to go over a brief summary. So if you want to have a rubric for students to fill out for the peer review, here is a test one that I created. Very simple criterion. And if you want, you can always create a new rubric right here, depending on the type of assignment you are creating. The next page is options. This is just when you fill out more nitty-gritty for the peer review assignment. Here is where you can select who is assigned to this peer review. You can have the entire class, or you can set it up to have specific students or groups or exclude students. Then you can also set how many submissions each student will review. For my assignment, I am just having each student review another peer's work, just a single other review or document, excuse me. The final phase is scoring. Again, more about templates in the description below. You can check out our knowledge base pages. And as you can see here, I have set up the assignment default. With peer review, there are five components that go into the overall scoring. Again, you can adjust it to your discretion. But the first one is the submission phase. So students will get points towards uploading a submission. The next is submitting in-text comments. So when they're in that second phase of the peer review, they are highlighting the document and leaving comments just like in a standard assignment, and they will get credit towards their overall grade for this component. The next, if you have a rubric, you will want to make sure to have this component turned on. And this is just giving students points towards filling out the rubric. From the author's perspective of the paper, students will also get scores towards their overall assignment by the rubric scores that they received. And you can adjust this by clicking options below, just like all the other components. And then the final scoring component is authors responding to in-text comments. So once we're in that fourth phase of peer review, students are responding to comments and creating threads and initiating discussions. When students write comments as a response to others, this will give them points toward this component, to this metric. Now we are going to look at what each phase looks like from the instructor perspective, and I have set up a dummy assignment. So right now we are going to enter the student submission phase. When you open this as the instructor, it's just going to tell you the submission phase is in progress. From the student perspective, this is where they're going to press a button that says upload the document. They'll also see instructions about the peer review assignment and just like a simple template of what your rubric will look like. During this phase, you will see the progress, the submission progress. So you'll be able to see who has uploaded what and at what time and who hasn't. If you need to submit a document on a student's behalf, you press add submission on behalf of student. Going into phase two, the peer review, student review phase. So when you open the assignment here, again, this is when the assignment is open to the students reviewing the other people's work. And as you can see here, I have the submission authors, and then I have who they are getting reviewed by. And then you can see if they have done their review. So this is just like a nice overall progress tracker. If I want to go into the assignment, here under assignment information, I can track deeper into the assignment. So right here, if I select from this dropdown, I'll see my two test students in my course, and I can select a student to view the review phase assignment from their perspective. So from my test student here, I am seeing what this looks like from their perspective and what they have already submitted. And as I can see, they have submitted their rubric and they have left overall feedback. I can also see the comments that they have left on this paper. Again, now going back to the next phase, the instructor review phase. This is when the assignment totally closes off from students. At this point, they will enter the assignment and will say instructor review phase is in progress, and they will be able to see the deadline right here. As you can see, mine says it is going on until January 16th at 11:59 p.m. Eastern. At this period, I really have a nice bird's eye view of what is going on. During this time, I can choose to include, if I have overall feedback, include it in my peer review. As you can see here, I do. If I didn't agree with what the student put on this person's paper, I can always take it away and hide it from the author when they are able to see what is being said on their papers. I can also add my own comments and add to the discussion threads. Now, when this phase is over, we will be in the author review and response period. So this is when the assignment reopens to the students, and the authors of uploaded work will be able to review what their peers have said. In this phase, again, it's very similar to the third phase from the instructor perspective. And in this phase, I can still keep an eye on what's going on. I can see what the reviewers of Ronaldo's paper, my test students, has what they have filled out, the comments they have left. And I can also see from this perspective what Ronaldo has reviewed of their submissions that they've been assigned. Again, this is a really important period of the peer review because it gives students the opportunity to look and deeper understand why they have been given certain feedback, and they can curate deeper discussions with their partners. If you ever need to review the work, you can always press grade assignment. And here you can click on the dropdown what student you want to look at, and you can see a further investigation into the calculation of their grade. And you can click these tabs here. So right now it's, the engagement metrics are open, and you can see the nitty-gritty about what the student has provided. You can also see the comments that they have submitted on others' work, in-text comments they have submitted on others' work, and comments submitted in response to reviews. If you ever need to change the grade for the assignment, you can just change it right here, and it will automatically be adjusted in the grade book. So if you have any questions about peer review, don't hesitate to reach out to support@perusall.com. I know that was a lot, and there's probably some questions you might have, and we're happy to assist. Again, you can email support@perusall.com, and things that I talked about in this video will be linked in the description below. Thanks, and have a great day.